Sri Advaita Srivastava Guru. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna. So we'll offer today's Srimad Bhagavatam class to John Poole, who is also joining us. He's able to hear because of the... Okay. So, we dedicate this class to him. And he was a student of NIT Suratpur many years back. He graduated, I think, in 2018. You have seen? 16. So, and he was staying in hostel at the time, and he was also doing wonderful services, organizing Janmashtami programs in college. He was also staying in hostel. He and his friends, Sachin Prabhu, Malai Prabhu, they were all staying in hostel and doing wonderful devotional service. So they used to bring big group of people for Janmashtami, which all of you experience about 300, 400 people in the college. So those are golden times. When in the college, we used to celebrate Janmashtami with hundreds of people coming, students coming, professors coming, dean coming, director also coming sometimes. So, and he was also very instrumental in doing book distribution in many colleges and schools nearby in Surat. We had this school distribution, Bhagavad Gita distribution. At that time he used to come and then he used to distribute books. So he and Sachin Prabhu and they used to distribute books in Puttur, in Mangalore, Udupi area, all those places. Now he was working in Odisha, now he is sick, so all of us can pray for him. Let's start this class with chanting once Hare Krishna for his health. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So today's verse from Srimad Bhagavatam is third canto, chapter 22, text number 15. So here in this verse, it is said, Rishi Ruvacha, Badam Udhodu Kamoham Apratta Cha Tavatmaja Avayor Anurubhosav Adyo Vaivahibo Vidihi. So here it is said that Kardamuni is now accepted. So what is the first class marriage? Arranged marriage. Arranged marriage is first class marriage. So, father and mother, they choose who will be the husband. Right? For the girl, they choose who will be the husband. And then they will get a marriage. So, that's the first class marriage. Because they do all the checking, background check, bodily check, and everything. And then they get married. So, that's the first class marriage. So because one more point Prabhupada is writing here, that Devahuti had given heart to Kardama also. Because when a woman gives her heart to somebody, she cannot take it back. That's the psychology. So the first person whom she got attracted to, she cannot forget that person. That's the Prabhupada writes here. Female psychology dictates that the woman offers her heart to a man for the first time, it's very difficult for her to take it back. That's why it's better for them to get married early. Very early. So I just going through some course of Prabhupada and the folio and Prabhupada history. My mother got married at the age of 11. So as early as 11 years, 10 years, girls used to get married. Of course, husband and wife friends stood together. They used to come together after maturity. to everybody. Prabhupada read that, no? Shri Gaurav Chakra at the age of 14. It's only in the older times, if you go to your elderly generation, so they used to give birth at the age of 14, 15, and then take care of them. And they used to have many children. By the age they are 25, already they have 6-7 children. And then the children, they take care of, they become busy taking care of children and the whole life goes. But here, in modern age, even at 25, 30, but still, they are not thinking about marriage. So it becomes very difficult for them to. That's what we can put that. So such a very old age, so marriage is going to be very difficult. So here, Karthu Muni accepted the first class marriage proposal by Swayam Bhuman. And Prabhupada also mentioned there is another kind of marriage called Gandharva marriage and Rakshasa marriage. So what is Gandharva marriage? Gandharva marriage is a marriage by agreement. I like you and you like me. So we both marry each other. So that's called Gandharva marriage. So Gandharva marriage was also done in the past. Not that in Prabhupada says in Kali Yuga mostly Gandharva marriage is only happening. Boy and girl like each other, they put garland, exchange garland, marriage is done. In the older times also it used to happen. Like Sita marrying Ram, or here you see Mahabharata, Subhadra, and of course Subhadra, that is different, Subhadra and Arjuna is different. That is Rakshasa marriage. Marriage like witnessing. So Gandharva marriage is arranged by agreement. The boy also likes, the girl also likes. They both agree to marry. And there is another kind of marriage which is called as Rakshasa marriage, where person comes and kidnaps. And boy comes and kidnaps the girl. So that's Rakshasa marriage. So some visitors have come. You can check it out. So Rakshasa marriage. So examples of Gandharva marriage are many in Shastras. So one of the examples is Dushmanta and Shakuntala, how they get married. Dushmanta was once in the forest and he saw Shakuntala got attracted. And then they decided to get married. They just exchanged garlands. So in Gandharva Vidhi, they just exchanged garlands and stayed together throughout the life. There is no concept of divorce. Prabhupada says that in modern age, they marry by agreement and disagree also by agreement. So they separate. But here in Vedic culture, there is no separation. There is no separation. An example of Rakshasa type of marriage is Krishna kidnapping Rukmini by the request of Rukmini. So another marriage is Subhadra. Arjuna kidnapping Subhadra by the plan of Krishna. So these are some of the examples of Rakshasa marriage. And Prabhupada mentioned that there are 8 types of marriages mentioned in Namo Samhita. But I tried to find reference, there is no reference for all 8. I could not find, but 3 are mentioned. Marriage by arranged marriage, second is by Gandharva, and third is by Rakshasa marriage. And all 3 examples in financial Bhagavatam. So here, how to apply this in our own life and how to make it applicable for spiritual practice, this concept of marriage. So I recollect one statement from His Holiness Radha Govind Swami Maharaj. Once he came to Pona temple in MCC and then he was giving the Brahmacharitas. So he came and he sat on Vyasasana and he said, "Now all the Brahmacharis get married." He said, "I am already telling you this." So then he said, "We should get married to Srimad Bhagavatam. All of us should get married to Srimad Bhagavatam." So Srimad Bhagavatam is Lord Krishna himself. He is Supreme Personality of Godhead. And Krishna in Kali Yuga has come as Bhagavatam. Krishne Sudhamo Pagade Dharma Jnana Divisaha
kalo nasht krishamesha purana ko mudita. When Krishna left this planet, but Krishna's grantha incarnation came in Srimad Bhagavatam. So we can access Krishna by reading Srimad Bhagavatam. So one should accept Lord as our master, our protector, our pati. Tumeva mata cha pita tumeva, tumeva bandushta sakatmaneva, tumeva dravidam cha, tumeva sarva. And in Srimad Bhagavatam also it is mentioned that all the Lord powers have accepted Lord as a master and as a pati. So we should also accept Lord as a pati, so to speak, brahmacharis. And then we can develop a relationship with Krishna. And if we develop this kind of relationship with Krishna, we will forget all our temporary relationships. Not only brahmacharis but all the devotees should develop this relationship with Srimad Bhagavatam very strongly. So how to develop this relationship with Srimad Bhagavatam? So acharyas teach us that we should develop this relationship by hearing Bhagavatam, by spending time with Bhagavatam. And when you want to develop a relationship with somebody, what you do? You spend time. You sit together, you eat together, you go out somewhere together, then you develop a relationship. So similarly, Srimad Bhagavatam also, we can develop a relationship by spending time with the book, Bhagavatam. Sit with the book, you and the book, and read books together. Then you can develop that intimate relationship with Bhagavatam. Another way is by hearing about Bhagavatam from devotees. How Rukmini developed attraction for Krishna? By hearing Krishna. She had not seen Krishna, but she heard Krishna. Jaya Shishi Jagannath Pade Sudamaya Ki Shishi Gaurita Ki Shishi Krishna Sindhya Ki. She heard Krishna and then she was able to develop that relationship with Krishna. Shrutva Gunan Bhuvana Sundara Shrimadam Te Nirvishakarna Vivarai Harasanga Patavan Rupam Drisham Drishimadam Akhiradaravan Vayyachyuta Vishati Chittam Mapatrapam Me. So something you have to do then. So here Rukmini is telling that I develop attraction to you by hearing about you from great source. A good verse. All of you can repeat. Shrutva Gunan Bhuvana Sundara Shrinvadam Te. Shrutva Gunan Bhuvana Sundara. Oh Lord, who is the most beautiful personality in the entire creation? I heard about you. Nirvishya Karna Vivarai Aradonga Tapam. And when this glories of you entered my Karna Vivarai, your bones, Harato Angatapam, it completely relieved me of all my distress or anxieties. Harato Angatapam, we are all suffering, right? Tapam means what? Suffering. Tapatraya, Tritapa, this we call tapas, sufferings. So we are suffering because of so many reasons. Athyatmika, adibhautika, adidevika kleshas, misery is due to body and mind, misery is due to natural calamities, misery is due to other living entities. And janma, mrityu, chara, vyadhi, these are all again the troubles which are there. But we will be able to. Is it in the camera one? One more. So only when you hear Krishna Katha will be able to become relieved from all the suffering. So example is Rukmini, she is telling him, when we hear about Krishna, we become transcendental to all the material miseries. So the constant hearing of Krishna is a remedy. Nirvishya Karna Devaraye Bharatam Katha. Even Parishit Maharaj was advised by Shukadeva Goswami that if you want to become free from the fear of death, what you should hear Krishna Katha. Second condition of Bhagavatam is in the first chapter. Tasma Bharata Sarvatma Bhagavan Ishwaro Hari Shrotavya Kirtavyascha Smartavyascha Abhayam. अगर आपको अभय चाहिए तो क्या करना चाहिए? भगवान के बारे में सुनना चाहिए, भगवान का कीर्तन करना चाहिए, भगवान का स्मरण करना चाहिए. सो दैट मेक्स वन फियरलेस, राइट? सो द पेन मे बी देयर बट व्हेन यू हियर कृष्ण कथा वी ट्रांसेंड ऑल दोस कंडीशंस, ऑल दोस प्रॉब्लम्स. निर्विश्य करण विवरे हरतम तापम रूपम दृशं दृशिमताम रूपं दृशं दृशिमतां अखिलार्थलाभं. She is telling that your form is the object to be seen by the eyes. Rupam drisham, for the eyes, your drishimatam akhilartalabham, your form is the highest object to be taken darshan of. त्वय्यच्युता विशति चित्तम् अपत्रपम्मे. माय कॉन्शियसनेस आविशति चित्तम्, माय चित्त इज फुली अब्सॉर्ब्ड इन यू ऑन अच्युत. सो दैट्स अ स्टेट ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस व्हेन शी इज राइटिंग दिस लेटर. Because I heard about you and have from your pure devotees, my consciousness is now only thinking about you and nothing else. There are many things in this world which you think of, no? Relatives are there, friends are there, family is there, job is there, money is there, bank balance is there, possessions are there, so many things you can think of. But your ministry, I am not attracted to all this, I am just attracted to you only, Krishna. So we hear about Krishna, then we will become conscious of Krishna. So the first point is hearing. Vayyachuta avishati chittam, the consciousness should become attracted to Krishna. Sometimes it happens that, many times it happens that we are physically doing the activities of bhakti but mentally we are upset. But many times it happens to me also. We are doing hearing Bhagavatam class, or we may be chanting Hare Krishna, doing services, but that thing mechanically body is doing, but mind is thinking something else. It's thinking about some anxieties, worries, troubles. And many times it is distracted because we think we are the controller. When things go out of control, we become disturbed. So these are some of the things which distract our mind. But here Rukmini is studying. Avishati chittam apatrapam, shamelessly thinking about it. I don't care what people talk about me, but I am shamelessly attracted to you, she says. So just by hearing about Krishna, she has not even seen Krishna, but she is developing this kind of attachment to Krishna. So see, also attachment to Krishna is not something which you develop at the after you die. Attachment to Krishna is developed even while in this lifetime. While doing sadhana bhakti in this lifetime also one kind of attachment to Krishna. But one has to hear from devotees, one has to read Prabhupada books, then one can develop that attachment. So that's how one should get married to Srimad Bhagavatam. One should know where is what, one should know everything thoroughly, which section, where what is being discussed, who is telling what, right? All that we should know, we should try to know the lessons, we should read and understand the lessons, we should hear from other devotees. And then we will be knowing thoroughly, front to back, everything about Srimad Bhagavatam, right? So let's say the person when he is getting married, he tries to know that everything about the other person. Starting from height and weight up to very job and everything. Suddenly we should try to know everything about Krishna. And there are not many books. At is Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, Chaitanya Charitamrita. That is the, we should be Sarvabhut. We are not expected to be Garuda Purana, we are not expected to be Skanda Purana, Guru Purana, Vishnu Purana. It is one thing we should be Sarvabhut, it is Srimad Bhagavatam. So we should be. How many of you are reading Bhagavatam? Started reading Bhagavatam. Yes, yes. So you should start reading. Those who have graduated Bhagavatam. All of you have Bhagavatam set. Bhagavatam set for that. Name. First salary. Bhagavatam set. Bhagavatam Purana. Bhagavatam Purana is still late. So, okay, we'll put it there, put that in the water. So take Bhagavatam and start from first canto and continue reading. Okay. So when you have Bhagavatam, you can read Bhagavatam. If you don't have, then mind bolega, nahi hai, baad mein padhenge. Baad mein padhenge, is post padhenge. Engineering mein kitna padha? 4 saal mein 50 subject, 50 book padha hai. And Bhagavatam to sirf kitna? 18 books. Ye 2 saal mein to ho jana chahiye. Especially for engineers, they have the habit of reading. So you can try to read and then try to understand. Get engaged and married to Srimad Bhagavatam. So that's what we can learn and learn the lesson from this section of Srimad Bhagavatam. So here, discussing about this marriage, let's discuss a little bit about Rukmini's marriage, how she got married. So when she heard that Shishupal and Shishupal is wanting to get married to me, and my father, who is the father's name? Bhishmaka. Rukmini's father, Bhishmaka, has agreed. Because Rukmini, the brother of Rukmini, he wanted this marriage to happen. Because he was also of Rakshasa Prabhupati, and he thought this marriage would create bonds. So in the previous times, marriage was a means to create bonds within two kingdoms. Yadus and Kurus, they were married and bond comes, right? Pandavas and Yadus, so marriage creates bonds. Arjuna married so many people in the 1 year of Vanvas. Manipurs came for Dhamma, Chikramgada, and then Urupi had met allies with Nagas, and married Subhadra. So because he got married to so many, and the strong allies were made. And Bhima married Idimbi and made allies with Rakshasa. So when Yuddha happened, all these people came. So marriage was a kind of way to make alliance. So Rukmini was of that mentality, so and the father was helpless, so he agreed. And then Rukmini was not interested in this marriage. So she wrote a letter through a Brahmana. Sent to Krishna, and then Ramana went running to Krishna, and overnight he reached and gave the letter to Krishna, and Krishna said, "You only read it. It is a confidential letter. It is a confidential letter. Nicely wrapped and sent." Then Krishna said, "You read it." Means what? Krishna trusted that Brahmana. Confidential letter is being read by Brahmana. Of course, a lot of beautiful discussion comes there of how Krishna inquires from the Brahmana about his satisfaction, about his practice of austerity and all the things. So here you can see how Krishna respected the Brahmana. And when he read the letter and Krishna understood the emergency, he immediately left. He didn't take any army, he immediately left. So means what? Krishna's prime business is to take care of his devotees. Krishna may be very busy, but his prime duty is to take care of his devotees. So he gives it the highest priority. So he is ready to give up everything and come. So that is Krishna. And when Krishna went alone, Balaram, he thought, "Bhaiya, akele hai, pura sena ready kiya." And Balaram ji piche nikle. Krishna already bahut dur se nikle. Krishna came later, Balaram came later. And Rukmini had also suggested she suggested that tomorrow morning I'll be going to Durga temple for doing puja, so that the marriage will be successful. So at the time, I'll be there with my friends, and that is the right time. Without much damage, much bloodshed, you can take me quickly. So she had very intelligently given that idea. And that day morning, next day morning when she went, actually she was anxious. Brahman had not yet come. So the morning she was very anxious. What is happening? But she felt some symptoms in the body, auspicious symptoms. Right? So it's some troubling of the right side. I think for Roman right side is auspicious. Left side is auspicious. So the left side is auspicious. So the pitching and other things were happening. So she felt some good gifts. And Brahmana came. And Brahmana was very happy. She didn't understand. It was done. Okay, just by seeing a person, you can understand. Happy means love is done. So then she offered obeisances. And she said, I cannot repay what you are, please accept my obeisances. And then she went to Bhavani's temple and then she was waiting. And all the princesses, many kings, they were all there. So they were waiting to get a glance of the queen. We decided that the princesses, they used to be given high security. Ordinary people could never see them. Never. So now she had made a public appearance, we were looking. But she was fully covered. But once she just lifted up to see where Krishna is. That's it. And some princes saw and then fainted. Ghoda Gopasa Girge. That was her beauty. So like this, she was anxiety, where is Krishna, where is Krishna? And then she sees Krishna coming on his chariot. And Krishna comes very near, effortlessly. Takes a rukmini in your hand, puts under her, goes. And everybody is watching. Then they realize what happened. They say, Akraman, fight. Uta ke liye ke liya. Krishna is taking a rukmini, let's fight. And then they all lifted their weapons and they start chasing Krishna. And then by the time Balram, fierce fight, but when Yadu Guru's hand, this Vidarbha army, Jarasandha also had come, many had come. So they fought, but they were very thoroughly defeated. And then Krishna also was about to kill Rukmini, but then seeing Rukmini, they have not killed. He gave a nice headshake, inserted him and left. Rukmini became pacified, happy, we didn't kill him, it was good. So like that, Krishna kidnapped Rukmini and took away that Rakshasa style of marriage. The lesson here is, Shishupal represents Maya, Rukmini represents all of us, Jivanas. Maya is trying to hijack or kidnap the soul, Jivanas. So the helpless Jiva at the time sends a request to Krishna through Guru, who is a Brahmana. So the Guru, as a representative of Krishna, very transparently sends a message to Krishna, and Krishna, hearing that request, comes personally to rescue the Jiva and takes us back to Bharata. Okay, once on scene, you are telling. Rukmini wrote a love letter to Krishna through the Guru, and Krishna responded. So our love letter to Krishna is Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. It's every day. So we can write this love letter to Krishna for 2 hours through the medium of Guru, through the medium of Srila Prabhupada. And then when that request reaches Krishna, Krishna will become pleased. Of course, that call also has to be as desperate as Rukmini's, as desperate as Draupadi's. Then Krishna will come. This way, reciting like a parrot, we cannot expect. Because mother knows when the child is genuinely crying, when what is a fake cry and genuine cry, she will understand. Similarly, Krishna also understands what is a fake call and real call. So when you have a real call, then Krishna will be attracted and come to us and rescue us. So this is the lesson which we can learn from this master. So we can try to chant with a genuine heart. And also pray for all the devotees in this world who are getting affected by this pandemic. So let's chant once Hare Krishna again for all the devotees. Hare
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Questions? There is no agreement. Like here, Rukmani was willing to marry Krishna.
So the style was good. That's where it's come under Rakshasa. Rukmani writes it in Krishna book. So Gandharva style is both the protection of the land and Narayana. Rakshasa style is Jani. Yeah, so see the point that Kshatriya kidnaps a girl and then everybody will attack. So the person should be ready to fight, only then marriage happens. When he kidnaps, and then do you think the girl's king, the father will keep it? Will attack. And if you are able to defeat and win that, then you marry. That's what happened. Krishna kidnapped, then people attacked, then he defeated her. So it is very bravery is required for that. You should be able to die also. You are not ready to kidnap and go hide somewhere. You should be able to face the world. Lakshmana and Samba. As he Samba kidnapped Lakshmana and then Duryodhana. Kidnapping him, put him in the jail. Not to be ready for that. So that is a rakshas style of match. No such people in Kali Yuga.
Even whatever we hear is also generally that of the Kshatriyas only they would do this, like not the other Brahmanas.
Brahmanas standard direction. Not even Gandhara Maharishi.
They don't have it.
Yeah,
Prabhupada also mentioned
Gandharva
marriage and marriage by
love,
which are also
accepted. It's the same. Marriage by love and Gandharva is the same. But that is good. The one way of benefit with marriage. But now Kali Yuga is happening, they marry by love, but the divorce also. That divorce should not happen. Hare Krishna. Shri Prabhupada ki. The best way is I am not.